We're going to continue on now with the same device control rule that we had earlier. And what we're going to do is we're going to look over here at our endpoint. We'll see that we're at revision 2. And also up here on EPO, we'll go to the system tree. Right now, everything is very, very abbreviated. I don't have a lot of policies for DLP. I have a monitoring rule that is being applied to my organization. There's no inheritance that has been broken, so this is for the entire corporation. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to go over here to the policy catalog, and I'm going to create another policy, and I'm going to say duplicate my monitoring policy, except now I'm going to call it blocking. I'm going to take this monitoring policy and the blocking policy, and I'm going to do different things with them in my system tree. Over here in my DLP maintenance group, I have a monitor only. And there's the monitoring policy. Up here in my organization, I'm going to make my entire organization now going to block it. So we're going to do a corporate policy blocking. We'll go down to my monitoring group and make sure that the inheritance has been broken. And we'll make sure that it's now set to monitoring. Now, what we've done is create an environment now where I have two policies. I can drag a machine over here to do monitoring for testing only. You could do a number of other things to make this happen, but we're just trying to keep it simple for now. Now, what I'm going to do here is go over to the DLP Policy Manager, and I'm going to create a duplicate of this rule, and I'm going to go ahead and click on it, and I'm going to change this to blocking. And we'll save it. If you don't save it, then you'll have to come back here and do it again. Go to the device control rule. Change this to blocking. We're going to leave everything else the same except the reaction. Now we're going to do a block for a removable storage device rule. In the box here with the three dots, we're going to choose removable. Hit go, and you'll see I already have one that McAfee made, and we'll go ahead and put it in there. And once again, we'll report the incident, and we're going to have a pop-up that's going to appear for 10 seconds. Hit save. So far, so good. That's all we really needed to do. I'm going to hit close. Now, the last thing I have to do is to go over here to my policy assignment. And now you'll see that I have two policies. But you'll notice that the monitoring policy was duplicated, and it's good for the monitoring and good for the blocking. Well, that's just not going to work for me. So we're going to go assign a rule set to a policy. In the monitoring policy, we will use the one that we have called monitor. Once again, I'll go over here and check the blocking policy, which now appears in the dropdown, and we'll change it to blocking. Perfect. Notice that they're both set to yes. One final thing to do, apply selected policies. I'll put a check mark next to both of them. And now they'll be enforced to the client next time they communicate in. So now when we go up to the system tree, you'll notice that in the monitor only, I have this workstation still in monitor mode, but I'm going to move him up here and I'm going to put him in company A in the workstations container. See you later. Now we're going to run on over here to the workstation. And as time would pass, it would actually communicate with the EPO server, but we're going to do it manually here. Now notice over here, it's in a monitoring status. This should show our new policy, which is blocking. And in a moment, you'll notice here that it does go to the blocking, and we're up to revision 2. Now, what do you think is going to happen when I plug this USB stick in? Oh, look at that. The file was blocked since sensitive content was identified. Now, obviously, I didn't put a file on there. I merely plugged my stick in, so I would have to change the notification to more accurately reflect what I wanted it to say. You inserted a USB stick and you could make a customized notification, which we'll do. So we'll go back over to the EPO server, go back over to the DLP Policy Manager, and make one final little tweak to our rule set for blocking. Click on blocking, go to reaction, and I'm going to make a customization. So I'm going to click this little box with the three dots in it and say new item. New item is going to be block USB device. You plugged in a USB device which has been blocked. It's about as good as you're going to get me to do this on the first pass. I'll probably have to refine that. Then I'll come over here and choose my customize block USB device. Hit OK. Perfect. Now that I've changed that policy, we'll have to go back over once again. Hit close the rule. And you'll notice that this has changed. So we're going to select the policy, and the only thing that's been changed is blocking. We'll apply the policy. Great. Now it's up to number 3. Back over to our client we go. And as we notice over here, this should pop to 3. There it is. So let's pull this out now. Plug the stick back in. And we should get our customized message. You plugged a USB device, which has been blocked. Let's go over to the device. Okay, we'll head over to the device. It's denied. There you go, we modified that rule to blocking. Oh, and one more thing. Let's go over here to the EPO server, and there is the blocking USB rule that it was caught by. There's the rule. You could actually click on 462 here. And you can see that there was a device plug. It was blocked. Rule set is blocking USB devices. There's the rule name, what it's configured for. And all the other additional information is in the upper right hand corner. That's it for this chapter for changing from a monitoring rule to a blocking rule. I'm Jay Appell. Thanks for watching.